Mr. New York. You're doing it right
I'm
there.
I'm doing all right.
You're
yeah.
Frankie Fibro's yeah. personal friend. You're Frankie
Fibro. Born and raised in Newark.
Get out of here, man.
Of course, yeah.
Look at you.
Yeah, Clifton Avenue, baby. Oh, not God. Far from
yeah,
the
Clifton
cathedral.
Avenue. Right. Oh, my gosh, right there.
Yeah. Every time I watch The Sopranos, I saw the Sacred Heart Cathedral.
I know. Makes all the Italians happy, too. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Well, and there's a sequel, and there's a prequel coming out, The Saints of Newark, he's calling it.
Yeah. I know, David Chase. However, from Newark, you came to New York, right? Tell us about, and listen, Steve Malanga, he's a fellow with Manhattan Institute, senior editor with the City Journal. We got a lot to talk about taxes and everything, but just for a second, 9/11, we were just talking to Gerard Fitzgerald and all that the firefighters went through and the first responders went through.
And everybody,
you went off to Jersey. They sent you guys to Jersey, right?
So I was here, basically, and we were stuck. There was no way to get off the island. I was at work. And essentially, my mother calls me and says, the ferry, they're just, Arthur Imperator, they're basically just... for free.
It's the Imperatore family, right?
So I got on the ferry, and it was the most depressing scene in the world when you got in the middle of the Hudson River and you looked and you saw just smoke. Then I got to the Jersey side, and basically there was no place to go because they weren't even letting cars come our way.
Yeah.
So I walked to the Meadowlands,
which is like
the Giant Stadium,
my
wife then came from the west and picked me up in the car because that's the furthest she could get. Everybody has a story like that who was on the island that day.
And it makes us just appreciate certainly all the first responders, the FDNY as well. So we're both from Newark. The taxes in Jersey, they're higher than New York, and we're sitting in New York. I see the taxes when I get my paycheck here, you know. They take out so much, you know. And you have now your op-ed is a brilliant op-ed in City Journal, by the way, if you want to check it out, about the services in high-tax states. What have you found, Steve?
Yeah, see, here's the problem. So for a long time, my neighbors and the people I know in New York or in New Jersey have been complaining to me about taxes. But what I noticed in the last couple of years is they're complaining also about how bad things are services. NJ Transit, Long Island Railroad, what's going on with the subways.
Yeah.
And so I started looking at this, and I started looking and I thought, let me look at the areas that everybody agrees government is supposed to provide services, infrastructure, roads, bridges, mass transit, stuff like that. And there are a lot of independent rankings around the country of the states. And I was shocked that the highest tax states, New Jersey, Connecticut, New York, Illinois, California, are ranked the worst in most of these government services. Airport's another one. Meanwhile, number one in infrastructure is Texas, one of the lowest tax states, no income tax. Tennessee, Florida are ranked like 4 and 5. So I started looking at all these different areas, and it really shocked me that one of the things that's happened is we've been raising taxes, and I think that it's been so easy for politicians to raise taxes on us that we're not even paying attention anymore to how the money is being spent. So it's not just high taxes anymore. People are complaining about the services in this. So that's like a double whammy, really, if you think about it.
And they're not even trying to address that issue.
Well, let me tell you something. There's not a lot of efficiency that we're talking about. You listen to the budget, the Murphy in New Jersey, right?
Yep.
You listen to New York State. And, you know, in New York State, there's really a separation because once you get above Westchester, things are not good at all there. And not only are taxes high, but services are really a problem there. So, and then you look at these like places like North Carolina, South Carolina, Tennessee, everybody's moving to these places.
Yeah.
New Jersey is number 2 in the nation in out-migration of millennials. We're not talking about older people.
Yeah.
We know they're moving.
Yeah.
And so one of the things people always talk about in New York and New Jersey is, well, the schools are good. We're paying all this money for the schools. The governor always talks whenever they go off, you know, to try to lure people here. Well, we got great schools. Mm. Here's what's going on. We're spending all these money to educate kids, and as soon as we're educating, they're getting up and leaving.
Yeah, it's amazing. New York, too? Millennials leaving New York as well?
New York, Illinois, and New Jersey are
Ocasio-Cortez may split then?
And do you know who's number...
Just kidding, sorry.
Do you know who's number one in attracting millennials?
Wait, let me guess. Al guesses. Number one attracting millennials. South Carolina.
Nope. Texas.
Austin,
places like Texas.
We just talked to Texas this morning. I love Texas. There's no. How do they operate with no property, with no state income tax, yet with the services, and they're the size of the 10 countries, for crying out loud.
Well, you know, it's very interesting. Well, if you look around here, frankly, we have a lot of laws and rules which raise the cost of doing everything. So look, we built all these subway extensions in New York State.
Yeah, yeah.
It costs on average $2 billion a mile to expand the subway. In Europe, where they have subways too, it costs on average $500 million, four times more. I just got off of the path, right? The World Trade Center path.
Yeah.
$4 billion that station costs.
Wow.
$4 billion.
Steve, before we let you go, we're still hearing a lot about doing away with the SALT deduction. That really hurt New York and New Jersey. That's true.
Well, absolutely, because basically the rich people were at least getting a tax break there. They've lost that tax break there. Cuomo himself, just a couple of weeks ago, says Florida is stealing our wealthy taxpayers. It's not a shock. Well, I don't know why anybody would be surprised at this, but it's gotten worse now because of the missing SALT deduction for wealthy people.
Should they restore the SALT deduction?
Well, who should they? Basically, Congress voted for it because Congress is not New Jersey, New York, and Connecticut
alone.
So they're not going to vote for it. We have to somehow persuade them.
Before we let you go, Steve Malanga, what's the answer? I mean, you could vote, not vote progressive socialist might be
well,
the start.
Well, I mean, that's obviously the beginning. But one answer is simply that not government is always a solution. Because around here, we say when there's a problem, government's the solution. Let's raise taxes and pay for it. Yeah. And then the programs, they don't work. Clearly, we're not getting the services we're paying for.
You're a smart guy. You must be from Newark. Steve Malanga, fellow with the Manhattan
Clifton
Institute.
Avenue.
Senior editor with City Journal. Good to see you again, my friend. Steve Malanga, thanks so much. Debbie's on the roads looking out for you. 9:51 on AM 970. The Answer. Hi, Debbie.